Duhang Bodhisami, Mutohang Mochaye Pare, Tinohang Tarisami, Sansaroga Mahabhayati. Good morning, Venerable Sirs, friends in the Dhamma. Today, we are celebrating very important day. I think all of you know, as Venerable mentioned, we call the Vesak Day. Do you have any idea about that word Vesak? Do you know the meaning of Vesak? No? Okay. Actually, it is the Sanskrit word, sometimes you have heard Vaishakya. Vaishakya, and then that word comes to Pali, we call Visakha. And when that word again comes to Sinhalese language, we call Vesak. Actually, Vesak is a Sinhalese word. Before maybe few decades, before few centuries, only Asian people celebrated this blessing day. Anyway, before few decades, one of Sri Lankan minister, he suggested this day should be an international day to the United Nations, and United Nations recognized this day should be a international celebrating day. Therefore, they recognize this day as the Vesak Day. In on that day, something very important happened. Before 2,662 years in India, the birth, enlightenment, and passing away of a person happen, we call that person the Buddha. So that is the day we are celebrating. He passed away before 2,662 years. This is the 63 year that we are celebrating. Therefore, this day is very important all Buddhist followers around the world. Actually, he was born as a prince, and he passed away twice. Do you believe? Can anybody die two times? Is it possible? Is it possible? Yeah, impossible. But it happened to Buddha. Because of, in terms of Buddhists, the Buddha, with his enlightenment, he died, or he destroyed all his defilements, all his cankers. Therefore, he died when he was 35 years. When the Buddha became an enlightened person, can you remember? When? When he was? How many years old? When he was 35 years, he was an awakened person. When he was 29, he renounced, and after practicing 6 years, he became an enlightened person. First, he died when he was 35 years. When he died second time? 80. When he was 80 years old, he died second time. Then, therefore, the Buddha died second time. First, he destroyed all defilement, and then he physically died when he was 80 years old. Therefore, he died two times. Then, anyway, the birth, enlightenment as passing away of Buddha is very important for all Buddhist people. Because of when we recollect the attribute of the Buddha, we are really the followers of the Buddha. I have limited time, therefore I think I cannot explain everything in detail. Now I am going to explain what I uttered a few minutes ago. Buddhoham bodha issami muttoham mocheye pare tinnoham tare issami sansaroga mahabhaya. He was, as I mentioned earlier, before 25 centuries. The emerge of a Buddha happened very rarely. Can you remember after 25 centuries, nobody became like Prince Siddhartha, like the Sakya Muni Buddha? It happened indeed, maybe millions years in this human history. Buddhohang Bodhisami, the Buddha who completed 10 perfections, sometimes in Mahayana tradition, 6 perfections, in Theravada tradition, 10 perfections. After completing 10 perfections, he became an enlightened person. Then we call the Buddha. The purpose of Buddha is to serve all sentient beings. Not only human being, sometimes not only divine being, all sentient being. The sheer purpose of emerge of Buddha to welfare of whole universe. Therefore, the Buddha who became enlightened, determined to serve the all people. Actually, he began his ministry with how many people? Can you remember? Five people, just five people. He began his ministry, he began his mission just with five people. Now can we say how many Buddha's disciples, followers around the world? It's impossible. Maybe millions, sometimes billion followers. He is still his teaching, still he is like serving for all humankind. The whole world, still he is serving. So his purpose is complete. His purpose is very nice. Buddhoham Bodhisami, he determined, I became an enlightened person. I want to make, awaken other people. Then Tinnoham, Muttoham Motiye Pare, his second determination was, I already prayed. I got rid. What? How he got rid? Because he got rid of death. Because of we as average people always doing good and bad action. As far as we concerned with good and bad action, we are bound with the samsara, with the birth circle. Birth circle, in terms of Buddhist, we can explain the death. We are getting rebirth and die. We are getting rebirth and die. Maybe in the form of human being, in the form of divine being, in the form of animal being. As far as we completely bound to do good deeds, we are not get rid of birth circle. Therefore, always we have to do good deeds, and then we are able to get rid of birth circle. Then when he became completely with good deeds, then we can get rid of Mara, the death. Otherwise, we have to go in the birth circle. Tinnohan Tara Isami, the third determination of Buddha was Tinnami, the cross. Normally we cross river or great ocean or something else. In terms of Buddhist, Tinna means the Buddha crossed the samsara. In terms of Buddhist, samsara is similar to great ocean. Is it easy to cross the great ocean? It's very hard. But in modern time, maybe we have ships and other sophisticated devices to cross the great ocean. Anyway, still it is very difficult. If we have to cross Bermuda Triangle, is it easy? Sometimes it is very difficult. Anyway, by that time, according to Buddha's similes, to cross the great ocean is very difficult. In the same way, to cross this birth circle, samsara, extremely difficult. But the Buddha crossed and he found the way, he found the method, he found the means to cross that great ocean of birth circle, samsara, and he introduced that nice way in order to cross the great ocean. So that was the three methods that Buddha determined to do upon his disciple like us. So that is the importance of this Vesakde. There are very important three suttas, sometimes you never heard, the Buddha Sutta, the Sutta of Buddha, and the second Sutta, Sambuddha Sutta, the discourse of fully enlightenment, And the third one, Samma Sambuddha Sutta, the discourse of fully enlightened. In those three suttas, he very nicely explained. First, let me explain the Sambuddha Sutta. You see, in Sambuddha Sutta, the Buddha mentioned four great miracle power. Have you heard the miracle powers? In Pali language, Chanda, Virya, Chitta, Vimansa. Chanda means we have to have the determination to practice meditation, to discuss his teaching, etc. Then Virya means we have to make our own effort. Otherwise, we cannot be real disciple followers of the Buddha. And Chitta means we have to make our mind, the third one. And the fourth one, investigation. Vimansa in Pali language, in Sanskrit also, Vimansa means investigation. Buddha never ever explained advice to his disciple, immediately accept his teaching. We have to investigate whether this one correct or incorrect, this one right or wrong. So that is the advice of the Buddha. And Sambuddha Sutta, the Buddha explained, we have six faculties. What are six faculties? Six organs. What are six organs? Do we have?
Eye,
ear, nose, tongue, yeah, physical body, and mind. We have to understand the authenticity, the reality of those six organs or six faculties. Otherwise, we cannot cross that great ocean of samsara. Is it clear? And in the third sutta, the Buddha explained Samma Sambuddha Sutta. We have six organs, six faculties, and we have to understand how to react with those six faculties or six organs. Forms, sound, smell, taste, contacts, and mind objects. That is the, in brief, I would like to say the teaching of the Buddha. There are a huge body of teaching of the Buddha that he explained number of times for his disciples. But in brief, if we can understand the nature of our six faculties or six organs, then we are going to understand this world. The Buddha mentioned, when we understood the authenticity, the nature of these five or six faculties, that is the way to be an awakened person, to be a Buddha. Because of each of us has the nature of Buddha. Especially in Mahayana tradition, it explains all sentient beings have the nature of the Buddha. That means every sentient being can become enlightened, awakened person. We have to understand, we have to follow, we have to make our own effort, then really we can be very nice, very understandable and fully awakened people. So that is the message of the Buddha. So today we are celebrating that important day. Let us make a determine to understand critically whatever the Buddha taught us. And let us make a better understand to follow the teaching of the Buddha and to be understandable and really awakened person all on this important day. Thank you very much.